That your speech was amazing. It was creative. It had an entirely new perspective to it, and I personally just enjoy it a lot.
Thank you.
So to start with, how does it feel to be a TED speaker now?
I'm still not over the fact that I'm a TED speaker. Like, what? I mean, I've always watched videos on, you know, from the TEDx channel, but I never thought I would be a part of it, you know, ever. So it feels great to be a TEDx speaker. Thank you. Like, I'm so grateful.
It's so good to hear. And it's a really positive response we're getting, so that's really, really good. So so if you were supposed to describe your speech in one word, what would it be?
Okay, based on the audience response I got, I would say captivating.
Captivating? Definitely. I was really captivated, I must say that though. So now your PowerPoint presentation, while you were giving the speech, the PowerPoint presentation depicted a pentagram over there. And you talked about how a pentagram is a positive thing and it just glows in positivity. However, you know, it's usually shown to depict Satanism, right? So what are your views about that?
Well, all right. So the thing is, the pentagram that we use in modern witchcraft is the normal pentagram, whereas the one shown in Satanism is the inverted pentagram. And as you know, most of the symbols in Satanism is actually the inverted version of the original symbol. So for example, the Christian cross is the inverted version of it. The same thing goes for the pentagram as well. So the pentagram actually depicts the five elements of the earth. So that's like earth, water, fire, air, and the spirit. So when Satanism shows the inverted pentagram, it basically shows that we don't care about your symbols. So yeah.
Alright, that's really good to hear. I was wondering if you'd done. So, now that being said, I would like to ask you one question. So you talked about witchcraft a lot in your speech, and I was wondering if witchcraft and spirituality go hand in hand?
It does. Well, the thing is, witchcraft speaks about a lot of elements of spirituality and self-care, mm-hmm. and that's basically what most of the religions practice, except in modern witchcraft, you don't really see it getting capitalized and, you know, being like, you don't see the evolution that the other religions have gone through with modern witchcraft. So modern witchcraft solely focuses on spiritualism without any form of capitalism being involved directly. So
yeah, that's really good to know. I would like to ask you one thing. How exactly did you come up with this topic? I mean, it was really different. It really stood out. I just wanted to know how you came up with this topic.
Well, so my mentor, Miss Samruti, so when she asked me to select a topic, at first I was going to go with gender fluidity because, you know, I'm gender fluid and I was like, I can talk a lot about that. But then when I was actually coming up with the points, I was like, you know what? No, I can actually talk about witchcraft a lot better than this. Plus, my parents think I'm a follower of Satan whenever I talk about being a witch. So I thought this could be a great opportunity for me to, you know, educate people about what witchcraft is all about, really, and just clear the misconception regarding it. Like, I was so keen on this topic. I was like, this is what I'm going to go for. This is what I'm doing. And it turned out great, so.
It really did. I mean, it did. I think your goal was achieved because it did spread awareness. Thank you.